Hello everyone, good evening, welcome to 9th and 10th channel of Byju's. I'm your teacher Ankita and I welcome you all in today's class where we will be discussing 10 very interesting competency based question everyone from tissues. So I hope that all of you are ready. Good evening everyone, good evening. I hope that all of you are ready for the class. Awesome. Good evening everyone, how are you all? Give me a minute, 1 minute. Okay, all good, right? I hope that you can see me and can hear me clearly. Are you ready for these questions? Are you ready for these questions, everyone? Thank you so much, everyone. Belated Happy Friendship Day. Yeah, thank you for wishing me. Wish you the same, everyone. Wish you the same. Yes, sorry for the delay and I was reading your comments, right? Ashwara ma'am texted that there will be delay in the session and of course you were sharing your marks. So everyone, how was your examination? Seems like good, right? Awesome! So good to hear that. Keep on working hard everyone, and you like, as we all know, right after the hard work we'll get amazing results. Awesome. Chaliye. So everyone, what we'll do very quickly, we will be looking at the we'll have a very quick recap, right? It's not a very lengthy session, I would say. We have 10 questions, right? And we'll be directly seeing through the PDF. Okay, so let's have quickly a very quick revision of it. Okay, everyone, please make sure you hit the like button for the video and please make sure you stay with us till the end. Okay, let's get started. Very soon we will be launching the midterm series also. So everyone, here we have what we have the meristematic tissues, right? So we, in this particular chapter, we're talking about the tissues and I don't have to tell you what are tissues, right? You all know what are tissues. What are tissues, everyone? They're the group of cells which have similar function. They could be similar and they could be different also. But when they come together, they have a different functions. And for example, if you talk about the xylem, xylem tissue, they have different types of cells. And of course, they play a very important role in the conduction of the water. So we have that as the tissues, right, everyone? Yes. Yes, absolutely. We will be sharing the timetable. I would request all of you, don't waste your time, right? Please don't waste your time in asking the timetable for the midterm. You know that we will be communicating with you. You know that once we have the timetables, once we have things ready for you, we will be coming live and we'll be sharing the timetable and the plan with you. So don't worry, everyone. Instead of wasting your time on the timetable, I would encourage you to please pay attention in the class today. Okay, chaliye. We are starting with the meristematic tissues. And what are these meristematic tissues? Meristematic tissues are those tissues, right? Very, very important. Now, they are the one which are a group of cells that perform a specific function. We call them as tissues. And this over here, the plant tissue is classified as meristematic. And the tissue that we're talking about, meristematics, are the one that keeps on dividing, right? There are very special kind of tissues that keep on dividing. And broadly, we differentiate them into the three categories. We have apical meristem, which grows at the shoot or the tip region. At the tip over here, they keep on dividing. And that is the reason we'll see the increase in the length. Now, some of the important characteristics about the meristematic tissues is that they have dense cytoplasm. They don't have the vacuole, basically they don't store the materials, right? Yes, so that's very, very important thing. Then we have the intercalary meristem, which of course is present at the base of the leaves or of the internodes right over here. This is the base and of course we have these nodes and internodes. They actually help in elongating the internodes. And last but not the least, we have the lateral meristem, which is present on the lateral side over here, we can see. And they actually help in increasing the growth of the plant. Everyone, are we clear with this? Yes, we don't have the mentee. Everyone, do take a screenshot of this. It's a very quick summary, right? It's a summary. If you look over here, what we have? We have the summary. So everyone, please keep on taking the screenshots, right? Ranjit sir, can we move a little towards the opposite side here, where we have the empty space? Yes, everyone. Yes, intercellular spaces are absent. Very good. Yes, okay, let's move to the next, everyone. What do we have the next? We have the protective tissue. Right, we have the protective tissue and protective tissue. What we have the epidermis, right? We know that the epidermis is our first layer, right? It's a topmost layer that we have, right? Which is present on the leaves, and it is kind of, you know, it is act as a barrier between, right? And of course, we have the different types altogether in the bark also. So the epidermis tissue actually help in protecting from the various insects. It act as the, you know, barrier, right? And of course, apart from that, it help in reducing the loss of the water. It prevents from the mechanical injuries and the invasion of the parasites too, right? Now, apart from that, they have a waxy coating, which we call it as a cuticle, right over here. And cutine. Well, many of you are asking, well, what is cutine? Cutine, can anyone tell me? Can anyone tell me what is cutine? Video is clear, right, everyone? Video is clear. Just in case it's not clear, you can change the setting of your phone, you know, or the screen that you're watching in, you'll be able to see it properly. Right, everyone? Very good. It prevents the loss of water. Absolutely correct. So we have the substance, right, that will be making the cuticle that we have over here. It prevents the loss of water and mechanical injuries. Then, of course, on the epidermis, what we have? We have the stromata, the tiny little openings, right? The tiny little, tiny microscopic structures that are present, right? And they plays a very important role in the exchange of the gases as well as the water, right? And the different gases altogether. So they're responsible for the exchanging of the gases and releasing the water vapors. Very good, everyone. Very good. Then, the last, everyone over here in the protective tissue, we have the bark or the cork cells, right? The epidermis replaced by the secondary meristem. So, as the plant will be growing, what will happen? We will see that the primary meristem that we have, right, will be replaced. The epidermis that is there, right, will be replaced by the secondary meristem. And we will have the cork or the bark, right? And of course, we know that they are kind of dead cells and they have a secretion of the suberin, again a chemical substance, right? What this particular substance does, it acts as a cement. Basically, it makes it impossible for the exchange of materials. So this is very, very important, everyone. And the last but not the least, what we have the root here that actually help in increasing the absorption of water in the roots. Clear, everyone? All of you, are you clear with it? I can see that many of you are asking about parenchyma, sclerenchyma, colenchyma. Everyone, please do wait. We will be discussing all of these in a bit. Yes, cork, right? So, of course, if you talk about, right, I'm sure you would have seen the brown part of the tree. Yes or no? I'm sure you would have seen the brown part. Yes? So, what happens? We know that we have the epidermis, which is very soft, right? Which is very, very soft. Eventually, this epidermis will be replaced by the secondary meristem, which is really, right? What will happen in the secondary meristem? We will see that eventually they'll become really very tough. Okay? So, what will happen? We will see the formation of the cork or the bark. Why they are being dead? Why we call them as a dead cells? Because they will not be able to receive any food or the water. So, they kind of being pushed. So what happens? We have this, right? So when they're at the center, of course, they'll be able to get the water and the food properly because at the center we have the xylem and the phloem. If not in the center, but of course they're in the middle, right over here. As the cells will be growing, what happens? They move towards outside. So as they're moving outside, what will happen? They'll not be able to get the living supplies, right? Right? Clear? And because of that, what will happen? They'll be dead. And they keep on growing. Everyone, are we clear? Clear, everyone, all of you, are we clear? Yes. The cork cambium is dead. Ranjit, can we delete the comment of Rajiv? Yes. Thank you so much, but we don't want such comment in the class, bachche. See, if you want to leave the class, please do leave the class. We don't have to disturb the class. Yes, got it right? Awesome, chali. Now let's move ahead, everyone. So we're done with the meristematic tissue, right? And now we're done with the protective tissue. And now we will be moving to the simple permanent tissue. Now the meristematic tissues are the one that keeps on dividing, right? They are the living cells and they are the active cells, we can say, right? Then of course we have another type, which is the permanent tissue. So permanent tissues are those type of tissues, or like they have the cells which will not divide, right? They have lost their capacity to divide. From the meristematic tissues, we will see that these cells will generate or will differentiate and will become the simple permanent tissue, right? They are the non-dividing cells. They don't divide, right? They're the non-dividing. In that, we have three important categories. We have parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Parenchyma, right, is very, very important. It plays a very important role in the storage. So we have the non-specialized, right? They are the irregular, kind of spherical, not so spherical, but they are irregular shape. They have a very thin wall and they're the living cells. They're present in the soft part of the plant and they help in the storage. We have two types of it, right? Two types of it. We have chlorenchyma, which plays a very important role in the photosynthesis. And then we have the parenchyma that actually helps the plants to float, right? The water plants that we have. So they actually help in the floating of the plant. Really sorry for that. Then we have the collenchyma. Now, collenchyma again are a very specialized cells which have a very special type of structure altogether. They have thick corners, right? What they have? They have the thick corners. They are the elongated cells. Now, if usually cells over here we have irregular or spherical shape, right? They are the elongated cells. They are the living cells, right? And they have irregular thickened walls. It's not that the thickened walls are there properly or throughout the cells, but it is very irregular, right? Then they are present in the stalk of leaves and flowers so that we can have some of the flexibility, and plays a very important role in providing the flexibility and support to the plant. Then last but not the least, everyone, we have sclerenchyma. They are the dead cells, right? They are the elongated narrow cells, and they are the dead cells because they have a very thick cell wall covering of a chemical which is called as the lignin. Remember this, everyone. This is super important, right? They have a chemical substance that is covering the cell wall, is because of that we call them as the dead cells, right? They provide the hard part to the plant. They are present usually in the hard parts of the plant, like seeds, the covering of the coconut, or the covering of the nuts, right? And then we have the function. They provide the strength and the toughness. Everyone, please make sure you take the screenshot. Jaldi se. I'll move aside. Everyone, are we clear with this? Yes. Okay, everyone. I hope you have taken the screenshot. What is the use of sclerenchyma if they are there? If they are dead, they provide the strength, bache. Right? Adit. I didn't get your point. Adit, please, can you stop spamming? Ma'am, which is present in the outermost part? So, of course, again, usually we say, like, in terms of the covering, right? If, for example, I'm sure you would have seen coconut. So, if the coconut, right, the husk that we have is made up of the sclerenchyma. Some of the seeds that we have, right, in guava, we have the seeds. They are made of the sclerenchyma. So, remember these things, everyone. Okay. So we're done with the meristematic tissues, and now we're done with the protective tissues, and now we're done with the simple permanent tissue. Collenchyma contain chlorophyll? No. Yes, no. Chlorenchyma. Again, there are two differences, everyone. Chlorenchyma and, right? Chlorenchyma and collenchyma. Chlorenchyma, right? So chloral. So remember the word. When we have, right, chlorenchyma, chloroplast, very chlorophyll, all of these, very similar. The next tissue, everyone, that we are discussing is the complex permanent tissue. And in complex permanent tissue, we have xylem and we have phloem. Why we call them as complex? Because we have different types of cells that are present together, right? In xylem, we have four different types of cells. We have tracheids, we have xylem vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fiber. And We know that xylem help in the conduction of the water and the minerals, and the movement in xylem happens only in one particular direction. It's unidirectional. Whereas phloem has bidirectional flow of the food in from shoot to root and root to shoot. And we know that it is made up of the two types of cell, right? Four types of cells. We have sieve elements, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fiber. Clear, everyone? This is the easiest part, everyone. This is the easiest part. You can take a screenshot of it. Yes! A smiley for all of you, everyone. And I think at the back, I wrote the incorrect spelling of lignin. So here we have the correct spelling. Okay? I think so. Yes, everyone, are we clear? Priyanka Kaur has a subrene. Okay, Priyanka? Lignin is present in the sclerenchyma. Got it? Okay, chaliye. Chlorenchyma contain chlorophyll. Yes, Shreya. Very good, Priya. Gungun. Vismaya. Where is permanent tissue located? Think about it. Permanent tissue, of course, there are two types, right? Simple permanent. Simple permanent and we have complex permanent. So, of course, when we talk about the complex and the complex permanent, of course, they are there in the xylem and phloem. We have simple permanent tissue we have just discussed. Parenchyma present in the soft part of a plant. Chlorenchyma present in the leaves and the flowers, right? And sclerenchyma in the hardest part of the plant. And, of course, some of the seeds also. Yes, chaliye. With this, everyone, we are done with the plant tissue. And now we are moving to the animal tissue. It's a very quick revision, everyone. Remember. Right? Yes. Very good. Yes, everyone, please do remember this. We have epithelial tissue, right? So we have squamous, we have columnar, cuboidal, stratified, and deciliated. Everyone, do take a screenshot, jaldi se. We have to look at the questions, everyone. Yes, interesting. When we talk about the squamous, right? They are, if you talk about the simple squamous, just a flat kind of tissues, not very regular shape, right? And of course, they form the very thin lining of the esophagus and the mouth, right? Then we have the stratified, layers by layers we have. We have so many layers over here. We will be able to find this on the screen and they play a very important role in protecting the skin from the wear and tear. Then we have the columnar epithelium, right? Present in the lining of our small intestine, helping in the absorption and secretion. We have ciliated columnar epithelium. Then they facilitate in the movement of the mucus in the respiratory tract. Because they have those cilias, right? It actually helps in the movement, pushing it forward. Then we have cuboidal. Provides mechanical support to the lining of the kidneys, tubules and the duct. Now, of course, simple cuboidal is very easy. Again, right, we can see that plays a very, very important role. Everyone, in your examination, for the epithelial tissue, the one of the common questions that they'll be asking you for the location. In 1 marks, right, or in the MCQs, they can give you the location and they can identify you to find the location of these tissues where they are present in. So, everyone, please make sure to remember the examples, okay? Good evening, everyone who are joining us now. Ciliated columnar pressure is present in the respiratory tract. Okay? Clear? So do remember this. Very good. They help in the... Very good. Very good. Ma'am, do plants have permanent... No. First, of course, meristematic tissues and then eventually. Yes, Priyanka. Absolutely correct. But we usually don't say that. Now, in terms of the cork cells, right, we always talk about the subrene and not about the lignin. Even though the cells are there. Okay? No. There are other layers also. Eventually, the dead cells will be keep on piling astha. Yes. Chali, everyone. Haan, abhi tak recall hi chal raha. We'll just quickly finish the recall. Now, then we have the muscular tissue, everyone. Take a screenshot. Now, in the muscular tissue, we have three types, right? In the muscular tissue... We have the three types, right? We have the skeletal muscles, we have smooth muscles, and then we have the cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles works 24/7, right? And They are cylindrical, non-striated, they are branched, they have uninucleated, means single nucleus is there. Involuntary, you and I cannot control it. Then of course we have the smooth muscles. Again, involuntary in nature, unbranched, spindle shape as we can see, uninucleated, found in the eyes and alimentary canal. And then we have our favorite, the one thing that we can easily control is the skeletal muscles, right? And then of course they are the striated, unbranched, cylindrical, multinucleated. Now this multinucleated is very important. See, multinucleated, we just have these skeletal muscles which are multinucleated. The smooth muscles and the cardiac muscles are non-nucleated. So this is very, very important. Voluntary in nature and found in the limbs. Very good. Yes, Shreya. 24/7 means work 24/7. Till the person is alive, right? Till the person is alive, the heart muscles will be working 24/7. Okay. Moving to the next, everyone, the nervous tissue, right? It's the biggest cell in our body, right? The neuron. And they have cell body, they have dendrites, axon terminal and axon. So dendrite receive the information from another neuron. Axon relay, pass on this information from the cell body to the axon terminal, and axon terminal passes the information to the next neuron. So very, very important, we have nervous or the neurons in our brain. Yes, very good. Yes, we can say. Yes, Shreya. Okay. Okay, very good. Priyanka, it's not for class 9th. We have discussed in class 10, so you can go and watch it. Asta, so pili, right, of course, it's there in the bacteria. Okay. These are structure actually plays a very important role in the self sexual reproduction in bacteria. Okay. And cilia, of course, they are there for the movement. Ma'am, where are the simple permanent tissue present? Simple permanent tissue present in the plants. Soft part of the plants. We have different types. We have collenchyma, which is there in the, you know, stalks of leaves and flowers. We have sclerenchyma in the tough part of the plant. Kuch samajh mein nahi aa raha hai, bachche. It's okay, Neelam. You can watch a session later. You have to watch the other sessions because this is a very short summary. Right? So we did the detailed classes before. So you can watch those sessions and watch this session later. Prakriti, suprin is a chemical substance released, right, on the cock cells, right, and they are there. Why is multinucleated? Why is multinucleated? It's a very interesting question. Just think about it, right? We're talking about the muscle cells and, of course, the need to have more of the functions. Multinucleated means that they have more nucleus. Very good. Okay. Chali, last but not the least, everyone, let's talk about the connective tissue. Connective tissue is adipose tissue. We have areolar tissue. Now, adipose tissues are the tissues that actually store the fats, right? Fats in a body are stored as the adipose tissue. They act as an insulator. So, of course, the question that usually comes from here is on the polar bear. Right? Polar bear wala question that usually come. So, adipose tissues are those tissues that actually store the fat and they act as an insulator and they actually keep us warm, right? They play a very important role. Then we have the areolar tissue, fills the space between the organ. These are the tissues that are present in between the organ and the empty spaces. They play a very important role in supporting the internal organs and help in repairing the tissues. Now both of these are super, super, super important. Okay? Yes, very good. And then of course everyone, we have the different types of connective tissue. We have bone, cartilage, tendon and the ligament. This ka difference I'm sure all of you are aware of. It's very, very important. Right? So we have the tendon which actually connect muscle to bone, limit the flexibility with greater strength, whereas a ligament connects bone to bone, flexibility with greater strength. Cartilage, of course, we have in our ears, just remember that. It's a smoothened bone, right, and provides flexibility found in the ear, nose also, trachea and joints. Last but not the least, we have the bone, which is the very, very strong and non-flexible part, right? And it plays a very important role in providing the framework to the body. Yes, so these are the important thing, everyone. You can take a screenshot of this. Yes, Aditya, please write your question. Ma'am, what is parenchyma? Shreya, parenchyma is a type, right, that we have of the parenchyma. Right? Clear? Very good. This is our recap. We have the competency question over here. The last bit, everyone, let's quickly take a look at the blood. So blood is a connective tissue that plays a very important role in the transportation altogether. We have plasma, platelets, red blood cells, and WBCs. RBCs plays a very important role in carrying the oxygen, right? We know that they are very important. Platelets help in the clotting of the blood. Plasma, it's fluid. It has nutrient, hormones, etc. And WBC act as a protector, right? They're very, very important. Chali, everyone. So with this, what we have? We had a very quick revision. Now, we'll just freeze the screen for a while. We can freeze the screen. And I will switch to the CBSE website where we'll be looking at important thing. Yes, everyone, we'll be looking at the PDF of the competency-based questions. Difference between tendon and ligament, Aditya? Tendon, right? Joint muscle to bone, whereas ligament joint bone to bone. You can just freeze the screen. Yes, 1 minute, everyone. Can you fix this, right, this part? Yes, everyone, give us a minute. Shreya, erorial tissue, sorry, parenchyma, right? Parenchyma plays a very important role, right, in the water plants to float, okay? Shreya, I've answered your question. If they're connective tissue, so why they store reserve fat? Interesting question. That if they are connective tissue, so why they reserve fat? See, everyone, so connective tissue is very important, right? Now, of course, with the word connective, right, what we understand, they're kind of connecting. And of course, for example, when we're talking about the storage of the fat, they play a very important role in the, they will act as an insulator. So if we have all the organs, right, which are aligned to it, if they have the adipose tissue, it's kind of connected, right? Yes, and they play a very important role. So they all are connected all together. Anyways, the adipose tissue is outside. It's not inside the organs, right? It's outside. Clear? That's a very interesting question. Okay. Did tissues are present in brain? Yes, we have the nervous tissue. Ha. Chali, everyone. So now we'll be taking a look at the competency-based question. For that, everyone, again, I'm just discussing it with you that you have to go on CBSE. Right, you will write CBSE in the on the internet, and of course you will go over here. You will click on CBE. Right, we'll click it on CBE resource. Once we have that, we'll click on the assessment. I'm sure you can see it, everyone. In under the assessment, we'll have these questions. I want all of you, if you're in class 9, 10th, right, please make sure you go through all of this. Right, they have very good questions. Science, if you click, we'll be able to see the PDF open. And here we have. Okay, chaliye. So everyone, let me just type the page number. I have the page number. I think the page number is 25. Yes, everyone, here we have the question for the tissues. I hope that all of you can see. Yes, who found tissues? A very interesting question. You can answer me. Okay, this is from the CBSE website. Everyone, I hope that you can see it. Everyone, quick thumbs up. Okay. Chaliye, now let's take a look at the question, everyone. Right, we will be looking at the question, and here we go. We have the, right, okay. So first question, everyone, I'm sure you can see the screen, right? So what we have the apical meristem is a type of the tissue that actually helps plant grow in length, right? We know that. Then Tina took two identical potted plants and cut the shoot tip of one of them. She observed if the two plants grew in a week after. So everyone, it's an experiment that we have. This is CBSE website. what website we have at CBSC. On the net portal, you have to write CBSC. I showed you. You can go back and see. From CBSC, once you click, you have to go on academic website. There will be four boxes over there. Sorry, six boxes. You have to pick academic website. Then as you go over there, you have to go to CBE resource. Once you click on them, you will have a page open. At the right top, we have assessment. Click on assessment. Right, you have to click on the assessment. Once you go there, you will be able to see the different parts. And over here, second option is the competency based question. So if you pick this, you will be able to find the competency based question. Okay, chali. Here, everyone, if you can see the question, everyone, I'm giving you some time. Please do open this. Right? Yes. Very good, Minds of Fact. She's trying to cut the monistomatic tissues and find his place. Yes, Diamond Yadav. Right, it will work. It's not a website which is restricted. I'm sure it will be working. Just see, you can refresh it again. Ma'am, if the plant is will not grow, presence of the monistomatic tissues. Okay, so what she's trying to do, she's just trying to take a look at the apical meristem, right? Right, she's trying to look at the apical meristem, whether it is growing. Right, at the tip. Okay? Yes, chali. Next part, everyone, this is a very easy first part that we have. And now we have a very, very interesting question. Now, see, everyone, we know that CBSE have said that they will be giving us competency-based question. Right? So, it's become super important for us to pay attention. Now, the questions are not easy. Right, the questions are not at all easy. Okay, very good. Okay, I can see that many of you have opened it. Right, this PDF, you have to go on page number 25. Very good, Ulma. Very good. Right, you have to go on page number 25. Bani Bache, you have to go on CBSE website. Right, and from there, you will be able to get that. You have to go on academic website, and then from there to CBE resources. If you can go back in the video, I have opened it. Right, I have gone through really very slowly to show you the steps, so please go there and watch it. Yes, CBE resources, absolutely correct. Very good, Ankita. Yes, no, yes. So here the question is, which of these conditions would have made Tina's experiment invalid? Right, which of these experiment, which of these things, if Tina would have done in the experiment, would have made her experiment invalid? That is a question. Hindi mein agar dekhe, agar isme se, in teeno cheezo mein se, agar, aisa kya hai? Agar Tina ne kara hota na ye steps, to uska experiment kya hota? Pura invalid hota. Let's see what are the things we have. Keeping one plant in sunlight and other in dark, this definitely would have made the experiment invalid. In any experiment when we are doing, right, we have to keep a control. Right, we have to follow the same thing if we are comparing something, right? So, if she would have kept the two plants separately, right? That is the reason. We know that if she would have kept both the plants separately, it would have been invalid. Yes, it had would been invalid. Second point, watering both plants equally. Again, see, this is how they have twisted, right? CBSE ne yahan pe itna bada twist diya hame. Question kya pooch raha hai, what is invalid? What would have been the invalid? So agar dono plants ko separately unequal water karte, definitely would have made the experiment invalid. So over here we have the answer, no. Clear? Clear, everyone? Yes, watering both the plants equally would have validated the process. Agar alag alag pani dete to experiment invalid ho jata. Third point, adding manure to the soil to only one plant. It's again invalid. So over here, first and three are, yes, they would have made the experiment invalid. Option number two, right, which is absolutely correct. Clear? Okay, chali. Next question, everyone. Next question looks, seems like easy. It's an MCQ. It's an MCQ. Chali, everyone, here we have. Why do cells of apical meristem lack vacuole? Is it because They store food material. Is it because they have thin cell wall? Is it because they have dense cytoplasm? Or is it because they keeps on divide actively? Yes, Ankita, we are trying. Very good, everyone. We know that the meristematic tissues lack vacuole because they are the actively dividing cells. And as they are dividing, right, they will not be able to store. If they are storing, right, when a plant needs the storage, when of course it have to do various activity, it has to conserve energy. And this way they are actively dividing. So they don't want to lose out that space. Okay, so option number D is the correct answer. Very good, everyone. Now we have a question on the stromata. Let's take a look, everyone, over here. Here we have the question on the stromata. Stromata are the minute opening found in the epidermis of plant leaves. Each stroma allows carbon dioxide, oxygen, water vapors to diffuse in and out of a plant's internal tissue. The question that we have over here is that each stroma is surrounded by a pair of elongated cells. What we call these cells as? Very good, everyone. These are the guard cells, right? What we call them? We call them as the guard cells. Interesting. This was easy, I guess. We have question number 5. This is interesting. Why do the desert plants have smaller and fewer stromata as compared to the rainforest plant? Think about it, everyone. Yes, we know that in desert plants, we have very few stromatas, right? As compared to the plants that are present in the rainforest. What is the reason? We know that in the desert that we have the scarcity of the water, right? We have less amount of water in the desert. So, what will happen if we have more stromata? The plants which are there in the desert will be losing more of the water. So, that is the reason they have less stromata, to prevent the loss of water. Very good. Right? They are actually preventing the loss of water. Very good, everyone. Awesome, trossome. Okay. Question number 6, everyone. And here we have a beautiful image. Here we have a question on the protective tissue. The picture shows cross-section of two chopped tree trunks. So we have a picture of two trees, right? Cross-section of tree 1 and cross-section of tree 2. We have layer 1, 2, 3, layer 1, 2, 3. Can I ask you a question? Which among these do you think is an older tree? Jaldi se bataiye. Which among these do you think that the right is an older tree? Jaldi se. Is tree 1... and this is tree 2. Which is old? Which tree is old? 1 or 2? Very good. The tree 2 is old. And can you tell me why the tree 2 is old? What are the reasons you are supporting to say, state that man, tree 2 is thoda sa aged hai, thoda sa booda hai. Right? Because it has a thick layer of sclerenchyma. Okay. More number of rings. Very good. Thick cork. Absolutely correct. Right? What we have? We can see that the layers, of course, the layer 1 is, it has definitely more thickened. Right? So definitely tree 2 is older. Okay. Chali. Let's see a question. Which layer in the cross section of both the plants is made of the dead? That is layer 1. Right? Because layer 1, of course, will have the dead cells. So the answer to this will be layer 1. Okay. Next question, everyone. Which question can be answered from the picture? This is I already asked you. Right? I already asked you over here. Clear? Which question? Right? Which question can be answered from the picture? So in the picture, we had two cross section, right? In cross section 2, we had thick outer layer. Right? As compared to the 1. So, of course, we can say that when the outer layer is more thickened, the plant will be older. So the question that is supporting over here is that which tree was tree 1 younger than tree 2? Absolutely correct. Tree 1 jo hai, that is younger. Okay, as compared to the old tree. Clear everyone? B option nahi hoga. Anyone, do you have doubt over here? I'll explain it again. Are we clear, right? Option number D will not be the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 6. Which layer of the cross section of both plants is made up of the dead cells? So, Ankita, the layer 1, right? The outer layer. See over here, everyone. Can you see this? Please, Harshita, ask your doubt. Yes, Prabha, very good, very good. See over here. Yes, Budh. We can see that layer 1, right? It has a tough outer covering. Okay? Yes? So what happens? What are we looking at it? Okay, why? Right? Which layer is made up of dead cells? We know that as the cells are moving away from the center or they are moving outward, what will happen? They'll not be able to get the supply of food and water and eventually they'll become dead. Clear? So which layer is dead over here? The outermost layer. Clear everyone? Those of you have doubt over here. Pragati, I forgot, I didn't see your question, but can you repeat? Yes, Angel, please ask your doubt. Yes, Prudhavi, yes. Very good. Chali everyone. Anyone, if you have doubts, please do write over here. Okay. Question number 8, everyone on your screen. Question 8. Which of these is correct about connective tissue? Yes or no to mark your response. We have 3 more questions, everyone. And then we will be finishing our session. Here we have. All connective tissue are highly flexible? No, right? Do you think all the connective tissue are flexible? The answer is no. Not all the connective tissues are flexible. We have bone as the example. It's not at all flexible. All connective tissue contains cells that are either placed in a fluid or in a solid matrix. Absolutely correct. We have talked about the aerial tissue. Very important connective tissue. Right? We have fluid connective tissue, which is blood. Right? And of course, then we have solid matrix where we have the bone. So the answer over here will be yes. The last is, all connective tissue forms the framework that provides support to the organs? No. Not all the connective tissue are actually helping in providing the framework. We have bones, right? Which is a type of connective tissue that actually provide the framework to our body. Blood cannot provide the framework to our body. Do you think that brain can provide the framework? No, right? So that is the answer. So what will the answer over here? No, yes, no. Easy peasy. Easy peasy, everyone. Okay. Moving to the next question, everyone. Last two questions. Let's take a look at the beautiful diagram that we have. The picture shows here 3 types of tissue found that in our body. We have flat tissue, 1 single layer, right? It's the squamous tissue. Tissue 2 is cuboidal, we can see by the shape. And then tissue 3 is columnar, ciliated columnar. Yes? Angel, I think I've missed your doubt. Can you please write your name? Write your doubt. Very good. Ma'am, it has a thick layer of sclerenchyma. Yes, very good, Pragati. Absolutely correct. Yes, we can say that. If not the sclerenchyma, we'll talk about the cork over here. Let's talk about the cork cells. Okay? Chali. Everyone, the question that we have is, the inner lining of the alveoli, air sacs of our lungs, is very thin and very delicate. Which type of tissue we will be able to find in the alveoli of our lungs? That is tissue 1. Right? Very, very small. Very thin layer that we have. Okay? Next question, everyone, or the last question of our today's session. Which of these cells is the longest cell in our body? Easy. Bone cell, nerve cell, stomach cell, or the heart muscle cell? And that's the easiest, I think. Nerve cell. So everyone, with this, we're actually done with the competency-based question. Right? Let me just show you how to access it, everyone. See, you will write CBSE on internet. Right? You will be able to see the 6 boxes. You will click on the academic website. Once you click on the academic website, you will be able to see CBE resource. Second, from the left in the last column, when you click over there, you have to go on the top right main. There are second option that we have. We have assessment. When you click over there, you will be able to see these questions. Click on competency based, pick the subject science, and you have the class. Okay? This is how, everyone, you will be able to get this. Okay, everyone, clear? All of you, are we clear, right? So, everyone, they were not very difficult, I agree. They are not very difficult, but one thing is clear for sure from all of us, right? That we will have the competency-based question, right? And of course, this is, we have it from the last year. We'll have more of it, right, which will be updated by the CBSE. And of course, on our channel, we have done various competency-based questions also in the past. We will be doing more of it, so don't worry, right? So please make sure you be a part of the channel. Please make sure you subscribe to the channel so that you can access all of it. Yes, we will have the doubt solving session really very soon. Don't worry. And those of you who are asking about the midterm examination, we have we are just in a planning process. We have planned a lot of things for you, for your midterm, right? Just give us some time. We will be coming live and we'll discuss the plan with you and the timetable. Okay? Yes, everyone. Yes, very good. Thank you so much, everyone. I would end the session now. Right, yes, we have to start class 9th ka second chapter of history. We'll do that. Thank you so much, everyone, for an amazing session. Please make sure you hit the like button for the video. Do share it with your friends and keep on learning with Byju's. Lots of love, everyone. Bye-bye.